Hello everybody, welcome to my class on further part of ocean distribution. So today's topic is the ocean distribution as an approximation to the binomial distribution. So here you can see in addition to this topic, I'll talk about some more topics in the later part of this class. You will see that I've also explained about the normal approximation and also the mode of the Poisson distribution. So first of all, we shall talk about the Poisson distribution as an approximation to the binomial distribution. So let an RV x follows binomial distribution with parametric values n and p. Then you know that from your concept in binomial distribution, that is mean is NP and variance is NPQ, and therefore the standard deviation is under the root of NPQ. In your previous class, you have also learned that when N is indefinitely large and P value is indefinitely small, in that case Poisson distribution becomes limiting case of the binomial distribution, that is from the Bernoulli trials, where N tends to infinity and P tends to zero, then your binomial distribution tends to the Poisson distribution. So here the things have been generalized. So you can see that here when n is bigger than 50, that means n is bigger than 50 supposed as large sample, and another condition is that if n is n times p is less than 5, then it is found that x follows binomial distribution np can be approximated by Poisson distribution with parametric value lambda equals to n times p. So this is the main condition that you have to remember when you are using Poisson approximation to the binomial distribution. I have one note for you here that you can see the larger the value of n and the smaller the value of p, the better the approximation. Alright, so in order to have a better approximation using Poisson distribution, it depends on how large n is and how small the value of p is. So all those sort of things have been explained in this example. So we are going to apply this situation to this example. So in this example problem, it states that in a certain city, the probability that a person has blood type AB is 0.035. that means we are given with value of probability. A random sample of 120 people. A random sample of 120 people means this value of n is bigger than 50. People is selected. Find the probability that there are exactly 5 people. Exactly 5 people means we can take 5 as the number of successes. People in the group have blood type AB. So this sort of example can be seen in two ways. Like one, we can solve by binomial distribution, and we can also solve this by using the Poisson approximation to the binomial distribution. And let's see how we do this and what happens once we apply both the methods. So originally, if you cogitate on this problem, it is the case of binomial distribution where value of n is 120 and value of probability is 0.035, and therefore your q value is 1 minus 0.035. Now if I apply the binomial formula, for example, like px equals to x equals to ncx px q n minus x, and when you put these values of n, x, p and q on this formula, then our answer is 0.166. Now same problem you can see using the Poisson approximation. So here, if you want to use Poisson approximation, you must check that whether or not the value of lambda is less than 5. That should meet like this. Lambda means n times p is less than 5, and n should be bigger than 50 in order to say that n has a large sample. So here both the condition met, therefore this is appropriate to use Poisson approximation, where x follows Poisson distribution with parametric value 4.2, and the same probability p equal to x we can obtain by using the formula of Poisson distribution. That formula is like e to the power negative lambda x over x factorial, and then we have this answer. Now let's compare these two answers. If you compare these two answers up to two decimal places, they are the same values, but it is a bit different in third decimal place. So although these two answers are not exactly the same, but we are very close to, that means we can, if you are using Poisson approximation, you are doing a good job. Also, if you would like to talk about when they can be equal, then you can think on this statement that the larger the value of n and the smaller the value of p, the better the approximation. So it depends on the reliability of the answer, depends on how n and p are given. So whole thing that how these two answers are closer and closer to each other, that depends on the value of n and also on the value of p. I now have one example for you based on the Poisson distribution as an approximation to the binomial distribution, and this example demonstrates that how we can apply this sort of knowledge to the problem area. So here in this case, you can see that the problem states that on average, 1 in 200 cars develops a particular fault within a year of purchase. So 1 in 200 car, what does it mean then? That means your probability value is going to be 1 by 200 and it is said that within a year. So we have already got the probability value in this case. And if you go to question number 1, it says that find the probability that none of a randomly chosen sample of 250 cars. So value of n is given as 250 cars. So that is value of n. 250 cars develop the fault within a year of purchase. So it is talking of the same year. So in that case, now we have to check that one sort of thing you have already got, like n times p, if you do that, then it is n value is 250 and then it is times the p value is we have 1 by 200. If you use the calculator or otherwise, as you feel it is easy for you to calculate, so it is 250 divided by it is 200 and then my value is 1.25, and this sort of thing you can see that this is less than 5. So this sort of thing is less than 5. And also, if you check the value of 250, so this value of n is bigger than 50. This is the large sample n. Since n times p is less than 5 and n is bigger than 50, you can see that this condition has been met. Therefore, we can apply Poisson approximation. So therefore, we have now x follows Poisson distribution with value n times p is 1.25, where you can see that lambda value is n times p equals to 1.25. Now the question says that find the probability that none of a randomly chosen sample of 250 cars develop the fault within a year. None of a random sample chosen means it is you are going to find p x equals to 0. So when you use this formula, p x equals to x, that is e to the power negative lambda by x, by x factorial, you know that value of x starts from 0, 1, 2 and goes on and on up to indefinitely large values. So here, if you use this formula, then your e to the power negative lambda value is 1.25 and x to the power 1.25 to the power 0 will be 1 and 0 factorial, x factorial means 0 factorial will be 1, so we don't need to write. And then take your calculator, go to the calculator to calculate this value and you can see shift ln, so negative sign, then 1.25, close the bracket again and then enter. So our answer in this case is 0.285047 or something like this. There are a few more decimal values. So if you round this up to correct to three significant figure, means this value is going to be 0.287 up to three significant figure. Now we shall move to question number 2. Question number 2 states that find the probability that in a randomly chosen sample of 300, so here in this case n value is given as 300 cars, exactly 2, that means our x value is 2, develop the fault within a year of purchase. So find the probability that in a randomly chosen sample of 300 exactly 2 cars, means need to find p x equals to what. So here in this case also, if you see your n times p, that is lambda equals to n times p is 300 times the probability value is 1 by 200 and these two are cancelled. So this is going to be 3 by 2 and this is 1.5. This is again less than 5 and n equals to 300 itself is a large sample that is bigger than 50. Therefore, Poisson approximation is appropriate. So although this is the case of binomial distribution, as Poisson approximation is appropriate in this case, so this is better to go through that approximation. And just earlier we have seen that when you use the Poisson distribution, there will be very little difference in the answer. So here if I am using Poisson approximation, then in that case, therefore we can write Px, x means here 2. So Px equals to 2 if I am using the same formula of Poisson distribution. That means e to the power negative lambda. So lambda value is now it is 1.5. And then this is again place of lambda. So it is 1.5 to the power x means 2. And then divided by x factorial means 2 factorial. In the calculator, here if you just replace this value by delete. So this is 1.5. And then we have few more terms here. So it is 1.5 to the power 2. So this is a square and then divided by 2 factorial. So 2 factorial means it is 2. Otherwise, if you like to press factorial, it is also possible here. So if you say shift and factorial is something somewhere here, yes. And your final answer is at this time is 0.2510214 and few more decimals. So if you round this up, if you write this correct to three significant figure, then it's going to be 0.251 up to three significant figure. So in this way, we can apply the situation of Poisson approximation in the problem area. And this is our answer. Now, you can see here that this example states that a manufacturer produces jelly beans in a variety of colors. On average, 2.5% of the jelly beans are purple. The jelly beans are randomly placed into cartons, each containing 150 jelly beans. Then you have to find a carton in question number one of this example. It is now a carton is selected at random. I think the carton should be like this. A carton is selected at random. Find the probability that the carton contains no purple jelly beans, at least 4 purple jelly beans. So what are given in this case here? A manufacturer produces jelly beans in a variety of colors. On average, your probability value is 2.5%. If you convert to the decimal, it is going to be like this. The jelly beans are randomly placed into cartons, each containing 150 jelly beans. So n value is 150 in each carton here. Alright, so if you are talking about in that carton, your n times p value is 3.75. And this value, you have seen that this is less than 5. So therefore, since you have now n equal to 150, which is bigger than 50, and n times p is 3.75, which is less than 5, that means condition for Poisson approximation to binomial distribution has met. Therefore, x follows Poisson distribution approximation to binomial distribution can be applied. So if you apply the Poisson approximation, then your probability, it says that how it is x equal to 0 because it says that no purple jelly beans. That means you have to find the probability that no purple jelly beans are contained. So here you can see that no purple means x equals to 0. Then x equal to 0 means if you apply the formula again, like e to the power negative lambda, lambda x by x factorial, and you have the value of lambda over here. And if you apply this formula to the situation, you have e to the power negative 3.75. And by using the calculator, we have this value. And when you round this up, correct to three significant figure, in that case your answer is 0.0235. Now let's see in B what it says, that you have to find the probability that at least 4 purple jelly beans. At least 4 means 4 or more, so our probability is like this. As we are using this Poisson formula, and if you say that Px is greater or equals to 4, it will start from 4 and we may never know that where it is going to end. Therefore it is wise to apply the complementary probability theorem, and if you apply that as usual, then it is 1 minus px is less than 4, and that means we are talking from 0 to 3. So this is the situation. And now again, if you apply this formula of quotient distribution to each term here, then your situation is like this. By using the calculator, your answer is the value in the calculator. You'll see that 51623 and few more decimals, but we require this up to three significant figures. So your answer up to three significant figure is 0.516. So this says that two cartoons are selected at random. So two cartoons are selected at random. Find the probability that both cartoons contain at least one purple jelly. So situation at least is applied for both the cartoons. So how it is mentioned in the questions, you can write here if you like, but you don't need to write all those sort of language. You may just start from this step, but for your better understanding, I have mentioned few things in word. So I have just taken from the question that probability bracket both cartoons contain at least one purple jelly bean. That means one cartoon contains at least one purple jelly bean and another cartoon also contains at least one purple jelly bean. That means at least one means x is greater or equals to one. So the at least situation has been used for both the cartoons, and therefore we can write x is greater or equals to one for one cartoon and x is greater or equals to one for another cartoon as well. Here you can see that there is the sign of intersection. Why? Because they are happening together, therefore they get multiplied, and hence we have px greater equals to 1 whole square. Now you know that in this case, from previous you have seen that n times p is bigger than 50 and this is less than 5, therefore quotient approximation to the binomial situation can be applied here. So we have done the same thing. So it is greater equal to 1. If you use the complementary probability theorem, then it is going to be 1 minus p less than 1, and less than 1 is only one value, that is 0. And then, so although this is the case of binomial distribution, as quotient approximation is appropriate in this case, so this is better to go through that approximation. And just earlier we have seen that when you use the quotient distribution, there will be very little difference in the answer. If you use this formula, like it should be like this: 1 minus p x equal to 0 means e to the power negative lambda value, and that lambda value is 3.75. So it is 3.75 whole square. And finally, by using calculator, our answer up to three significant figure is 0.954. Okay, lastly I will talk about one more example so that your work will be easy going once you enter to the exercise problem. Now this example states that an aircraft has 240 seats. Past records so that on average 2% of people who have booked tickets for a flight do not turn up. The airline sells 244 tickets for a particular flight. Using a suitable approximation, find the probability that exactly 4 people do not turn up for the flight. So in this case, you have to adopt the possibility that understanding the problem is more than halfway to the solution. So this is good to first read out the question, then analyze the question and draw out the main points from the question, and then proceed to solving it. So here you can point out on an aircraft has 240 seats, and the past records show that on average 2%, that means is the probability value given, and then tickets for a flight do not turn up. Yes, the airline sells 244 tickets for a particular flight. Now you can see here there are 2n. It appears like as if there are 2n. Then you should be able to recognize which one we are going to use to our problem area. So compare these two values. This is for the number of seats available, and this is for the number of bookings. So at this point, it says that exactly 4 people do not turn up for the flight. So number of seats is 240, and you can see that number of ticket sale is 244. This is likely that those people will arrive who have booked the ticket. Therefore, we take 244 as value of n, and this value of n is bigger than 50. And when you multiply this value of n with the given probability 2%, that is 0.02, then our n times p value is 4.88, and this is less than 5. So you can see that as n is bigger than 50, n times p is less than 5. Therefore, quotient approximation to binomial distribution can be applied in this case, where you can see that the lambda value is 4.88. Now we shall think about this question. It says that exactly 4 people do not turn up for the flight. So x you can suppose as a random variable, and that represents number of passengers who do not turn up. So therefore, according to the question, x follows quotient distribution with 4.88 after being applied the sense of approximation. So here we have px equal to 4, and then you use the same formula, e to the power negative lambda x by x factorial, and you put the value of lambda as 4.88, and then you have this situation. After, by using calculator, you can get this value up to many decimal places, but if you require that that up to the 3 significant figure, your answer is 0.180. You can have a look. Now I can see there are another parts also in the same example. So in this case, you can see that there are empty seats on the fly. So you have to find the probability that there are empty seats on the fly. So how the seat will be empty? There are altogether 246. If any of seat is 240, so if you suppose y as the random variable that represents the number of people who turn up, then if y is less than 240, that means there is at least one seat vacant over there. So minimum number of seat should be empty is 1, and then it goes on increasing based on this situation. Now conversely, what you can say that there are 244 bookings, you can see here. So out of 244 bookings, there are only 240. So in order to have empty seats in the flight, there must be 5 or more people who do not turn off for the flight. And therefore, conversely, if you use x as the people who do not turn off, then x is greater or equals to 5. And now this is the usual way of calculating the probability. So we have used complementary probability over here. So it is 1 minus p, x is less than 5. And then we use the same formula, like e to the power negative lambda x by x factorial for x equal to 0, 1, 2, and etc. like this. And when you apply this formula, we have this situation. And then by using the calculator, we have values like this. And after you round it off, correct to 3 significant figure, your answer is 0.538. Now think about question number 3 from the same example. So here it states that there are not enough seats for everyone who turns off for the flight. That means we are going to find probability that not enough seat. When is it possible? So they have got 244 booking, but they have only 240 seats. That means this y, that is the number of people who turned up, will become more than 240, then there will be no enough seats because the flight has only 240. So now px bigger than 240 means y value is 241, 242, 243, 244, not more than that, because there is only 244 booking. Okay, so now y is for the people who turn up and x is for people who didn't turn up. That means out of 244, if 241 turn up, that means how many didn't turn up? 244 minus 241, that is equal to 3. And the similar thing you can check for 242, 243 and 244. We have situation like this. Now using this formula, we have this situation over here by using the Poisson distribution formula. And also in this case also you can use the Poisson approximation, because we are taking the same lambda value, and that lambda value is less than 5, and also n is bigger than 50. So in that case, once you use your calculator, your value is like this, and if you round this up to 3 significant figure, your answer is 0.282.
At this time, I am going to discuss about the vertical line diagram for the Poisson probability distribution. This is important to discuss about the distribution in different ways, and the objective to draw these diagrams for the Poisson distribution probability formula is that in order to know the nature of the Poisson distribution. Although we don't have question directly from this sort of thing in exam, but once we understand the probability distribution for Poisson in terms of the diagram, how it shows its nature with the probability. So once you understand about this, you'll be even confident in understanding and in the application of Poisson distribution. So let's see here. At this time, what I have taken, let a random variable x has Poisson distribution with parametric value lambda for different values of lambda. So these are the bar diagrams for the quotient distribution for different values of parameter lambda here in this case. So these values at this time I have taken as 1, lambda equal to 1, lambda equal to 1.6, lambda equal to 2, we can see 2.2, 3, 3.8, 5, 10 and etc. So I have taken up to 10 in this case. When you calculate the probability by using, for example, quotient formula equals to e to the power negative lambda over then times lambda x over x factorial, and then for each value of x like 0, 1, 2, 3, then at each point, if you plot the probability, you will have vertical bar like this. Okay, and a similar work you can do for rest of the probability with different parameters like 1.6, 2 and something like that. But most important point is to understand is there here. So in one part you can say that 1 as a whole number and also 2 as a whole number, and what are the other whole numbers that we have mentioned here? Yes, 3, 5 and 10. In each case of the whole numbers you can see that two bars have the same height. Two bars have the same height means there are two maximum probability. If there are two maximum probability, in that case the distribution at that particular value of lambda has two modes. So I'm taking the reference of one as whole numbers, it has two modes. So its mode values are values occurs at x equals to, you can see here, at x equal to 0 and x equal to 1. So therefore it has two modes at x equal to 0 and x equal to 1. So in that case we can say that the quotient distribution is bimodal distribution. And similar thing you can see at this point as well, like here also 2 is a whole number, you can see it, and in that graph also you can see that the maximum probability are here, there are two maximum probability, that means two values of x have maximum frequency there. It means what? In this case also, if you talk about the mode of this case, here it is going to be mode equals to, it happens at 1 and also it happens at 2. So in this case also, the quotient distribution is bimodal. And you can see that 2 is a whole number. And similarly, if you have look at other whole numbers, value for lambda, so here lambda equals to 3 at this point, and then your bar graph is like this. Here also you can see that it has two vertical bars have the same height, that means they have the same probability. So in this case also the quotient distribution is bimodal. This is also the bimodal distribution. Alright, and then similarly for lambda value equals to 5, you can see this measure is bimodal measure. Here also at lambda equals to 10 is of bimodal nature. That means at every whole number value of lambda, the quotient distribution shows bimodal nature. Now what about the other numbers which are not the whole numbers? For example, 1.6 you can see, and then 2.2, 3.8 and something like this. And then if I am talking at 1.6, what I can see here in this case, there is only one bar whose probability is maximum. So its mode happens at x equals to 1 only. So it has only one mode. So this is called the unimodal. Quotient probability distribution is unimodal when the lambda value is not the whole number. And similarly, you can check for another like 2.2. It has also only one mode, that is here mode value is 2. And then at this point also this is 3.8 is not the whole number. So at this point also you can see that this is the unimodal. So if lambda value is not the whole number, what you can see that the given quotient distribution is unimodal. So this sort of thing we have got now. So in order to find the mode of this distribution, what we have to first check that when the number is the whole number, you always see that there should be two more values. So in that case, we have to look for two more values. Now, when you see if lambda is not the whole number, there is only one more values. And the more value or more values occur at the point where the probability is maximum. And like we have just discussed about how to find the mode or how to recognize the mode for the Poisson distribution. So in that case, what I can say here, it is mode 1, right? And then here it is mode 2, and then here it is mode. At this point, if you see the mode value is only one, that is 3, because the maximum probability occurs at x equals to 3. Then what can you think about this sort of thing, that how to find the mode? By relating the value of mode with the value of Poisson distribution parameter lambda. In this case, if you talk about this is 1.6 and the mode equals to 1. That means this is the one in the 1.6, the whole number part is 1. So mode value is always from the whole number part, even though this number is not the whole number. So similarly, you can see it, see for another parametric value, it is 2.2, then your mode value is 2. So this is the place for the whole number in the parametric value. So you can see that if lambda value is 2.2, your mode is going to be 2. Similarly, if your lambda value is 3.8, your mode is going to be 3. What if it is 3.9? That will still be 3. Alright? It was the another feature of the mode of Poisson distribution. So we talk about single mode and the double mode for this Poisson distribution. Now you have another feature also that you can discuss here. Another feature is that, so if you can have look at all these diagrams and all these values of lambda, in that case what you can see, like the value of lambda is 1, 1.6, 2, 2.2, 3. In fact, these numbers are not in order but in the increasing sense. So when you keep on increasing the value of lambda, then you are drawing the vertical bar diagram. In that case, what you can see here, as the value of lambda has increased, the shape of this bar diagram is also different gradually. In that case, if you consider the curve like this, for example, if I am considering the curve from top of each bar, then my curve shape is like this. Now it has been increased a bit more from 1, so my nature of curve is something like this. And then for another increased value like 2, my nature of curve is something like that. Okay, and similarly for here, if I consider the nature of this curve from taking the reference of top of each bar, and then for this diagram my curve will be something like this, and for this it will be something like that. Are you observing something here as the value of lambda is increasing? And then here my curve looks like that. If I consider curve from on top reference point of each bar, then my curve is this. So what did you observe? What did you observe when you have increasing value of lambda, and accordingly you have been drawing the graph of the distribution? You can see as value of lambda increases gradually from lower to higher, in that case your curve is taking the shape of some sort of symmetrical distribution, and that sort of property is going to be used in the normal approximation to the Poisson distribution. So this will be helpful in understanding the normal approximation to the Poisson distribution. Now, I will now discuss what is the mean and variance of the Poisson distribution. In this case, let x follows Poisson distribution with parametric value lambda, that means the average value is lambda. Now you know that mean is equals to expectation of x, and if x would be the case of binomial distribution with parametric value n and t. In that case, your expectation would be n times of t. And from your previous class, you know that t is equals to lambda by n. If you extend, if you move forward from this step, it's going to be n times in place of t, you can write lambda by n. And these two things have been cancelled out, and then it is lambda. So mean of this distribution is found to be lambda. This distribution means the Poisson distribution formula is p x equals to x equals to e to the power minus lambda lambda x over x factorial, where value of x will be 1, 0, 1, 2, it will go up to infinity. So what about the variance? So variance of this distribution, you can write this as variance of x. And for example, if that would be binomial distribution, your variance would be, so mean of binomial distribution is n times p, and variance of the binomial distribution is n times p times q, that we have already done in binomial distribution. So variance is here n times p times q. So after that, n times p value is lambda by n, and your q value is definitely going to be, that is 1 minus p, that is 1 minus p is lambda by n. So it's going to be 1 minus lambda by n. And then you can see here n and n are cancelled out, and this is lambda 1 minus lambda by n. Now you know that from your previous class, that when n is indefinitely large, that is when n tends to infinity, your binomial distribution tends to Poisson distribution with parametric value lambda. So in this case, when n tends to infinity, your variance of binomial distribution will be tends to Poisson distribution. So as n tends to infinity, in that case you can see that this is lambda 1 minus lambda by infinity, close the bracket, and then you know that this is lambda and this is 1 minus lambda is a number, it has some value, and this is a number, so any number divided by infinity will be 0. So that this is lambda times 1, and that is equals to lambda. This is surprisingly that we have the same value of mean and variance, and we can see in this way. There are some other methods also to prove that how the mean and variance of lambda, but at this time we don't need that detail, especially in proving the thing. So at this time we are going to understand it in the applied sense. So this is not necessary that to go in that much detail of proof. So in this case we can simply see that here personally n has cancelled out from numerator and denominator. So here we did not to talk about n tends to infinity something, but in fact there is also. But here in this case, we are taking the variance formula for binomial distribution, and now we have this situation. So this sort of thing tends to the Poisson distribution only when n tends to infinity. So when n tends to infinity, that means this sort of thing are for the Poisson distribution. Therefore, when n tends to infinity, then we obtain the thing is for the Poisson distribution. Therefore, by using n tends to infinity, we have found that variance of the Poisson distribution is also lambda. That is, they have got the same mean and variance. So, therefore, you can say that mean equals to variance equals to lambda when a random variable x follows Poisson distribution with parametric value lambda, and your quadratic function is p x equal to x, just like that, e to the power negative lambda times lambda to the power x by x factorial, where x is the number of success, and then values of x will be like 0, it starts from 0, 1, 2, so on up to infinity. Now, for example, if you say x follows Poisson distribution with parametric lambda, then mean Ex equals to what and Vx equals to 1. So, in that case, you can see that the lambda value is 1.6, therefore, its mean is expectation of x, and just now we have seen that that value is lambda, so lambda means here 1.6. And variance is also, this is Vx and that is equals to, variance is also lambda, that is equals to mean, and hence that is equal to lambda, and hence it is again 1.6. So in this case, we can say that 1.6 is for both, that is for mean and that is for the variance of the distribution error. Okay, now we shall move forward to the concept of applying normal approximation to the Poisson distribution.
We shall now see the normal distribution as an approximation to the Poisson distribution. So, it has been devised in order to make our process while finding solution to the problem even easier. So, therefore, there is need of normal distribution as an approximation to the Poisson distribution, and that sort of thing I will discuss again after I solve this problem. So, first of all, just earlier we had seen that we had worked up till lambda equals to 10 and our curve was nearly symmetrical, that is nearly bell-shaped. Now, in this case, if you increase the value even further to lambda equals to 15, our bar graph is like this. And also we had discussed that when lambda is a whole number, the Poisson distribution is bimodal. So therefore you can see that there are two vertical bars having the same, that means they have the same maximum probability. And let's again consider a curve. There are a few more bars like this, and then if you consider the curve passing through on top of the bar, so in that case you can see that as I consider curve like this, it's near to the normal curve. So what you can say here, although this is a graph from the Poisson distribution, that states that its probability function is e to the power minus negative lambda times lambda to the power x factorial, but when value of lambda is 15, value of lambda was when 10, it was nearly the symmetrical shape, the curve was. And now we have further increased the value of lambda to 15, it is again very close to the symmetrical shape. In that case, we can say that this sort of thing now fits to the normal distribution case. So here we can see that this sort of curve is very near to the normal distribution curve. Therefore, you can apply the situation of normal distribution in order to devise for the Poisson distribution, that is. So therefore, first of all, if x follows Poisson distribution, then it can be approximated by x follows normal distribution with mean value mu, and we have seen also that its variance value sigma square is also sigma square we call in normal distribution, but here in Poisson distribution it was also found to be lambda. Therefore, we can say that we are trying to approximate through normal distribution where mean mu is lambda and also the variance is sigma square, because this is the condition. So when your condition meet, like if lambda is bigger than 15, then it can be approximated by normal distribution case. And based on this, I'm going to solve a problem. So here you can see, if x follows Poisson distribution with parametric value lambda equals to 24, use a suitable approximation to find this probability. Use a suitable approximation to find. In your problem area, it will usually ask you that use a suitable approximation. That means whenever it says that use the suitable approximation,
you have to analyze the question first of all. When you analyze the question first of all, then you will be able to understand whether to approximate through the normal distribution or through the other sort of distribution. At this time, I am talking of the normal distribution where you have seen that the approximation is appropriate when lambda is bigger than 15. So, if I am talking of the solution for 1, where it is said that x follows quotient distribution with parametric value 24, therefore your lambda value in this case is 24, and you can see this value as bigger than 15, therefore normal approximation is appropriate. This is not for only the question number 1, that's for all the questions under this question. So therefore the normal approximation is appropriate, where you can see that its mu value is lambda and sigma squared, that is variance for the normal distribution is sigma squared, that is also lambda, because we are relating that to the quotient distribution, and that gives you sigma equals to under root of lambda. So you have now mean as lambda and standard deviation as under root of lambda. So under root of lambda means if you put this value, so your mu value is going to be here 24, and your sigma value is going to be here under root 24. Now what you need to find actually in question number 1, now you are going to find px is less than or equals to 25. Okay. So as we are going to find px is less than or equals to 25, we have to look at this diagram. So what we are going to find actually, for example, this is 25. So for my convenience, although its height is very small here in the graph, I'm just trying to zooming it in order to get to the probability value. So it is 25, and this is in fact a small bar, but for my convenience, I'm considering some other lines, and I'll put something here. This is 26 and this is 27. Behind this, it is going to be 24, and then if I consider something like this, if you talk about 20, 25, 15, all these are discrete points. And when these are discrete points, then the case for continuous distribution cannot be applied, because normal distribution is a continuous distribution. But this is the condition where lambda is bigger than 15. We have seen that this is very near to the normal distribution. Therefore, it can be approximated through the normal distribution case. So, in fact, this is not normal, but we are going to approximate through the normal distribution. So this is 25 here, and this is not the continuous point. Then we suppose this as continuous point, another is continuous point. Then this is 25, and then other should be here. This is 26, and this is in between, and then it is 27. So in fact, 25 is not at the continuous point. 24, neither 24, 26, or 27. But by taking the reference of half unit towards either side of 25, 24, 26, 27, 15, etc., we can consider them to be the histogram, and that reflects the nature of continuous data. So for example, if I have 25 here, so if I am talking of half unit left, then it is going to be 24.5, and half unit right, from here it is going to be 25.5. And similarly, for if I am talking for this is 24, so here it is already connected with 24.5, and 24 is itself is the discrete point. Now its neighborhood is 23.5, little difference, and the similar thing will keep on going to the other side. So here the things are not the continuous, but we have made little adjustment by 0.5 in order to make them continuous in case when lambda is bigger than 15. This sort of thing will not be possible for the values less than 15. So in this case, because 25 itself is not at the continuous point, in that case what we have to do, we have to do
continuity corrects. Why we need correction? Because there is something wrong in general, but there is very little wrong. That's why we have adjusted the points in order to make that this create a continuous distribution, or that should supposed to overlap with continuous distribution. Therefore, there requires correction, and that sort of correction is called continuity correction, because we are converting that discrete sort of thing into continuous with a little difference. So with little difference here, what you can do, px. Now let's see what happens in this case. So x is less or equals to 25. What does it mean? X is less or equal to 25, that means x starts from 0 and ends to 25. It means x is also including the number 25, but 25 itself is not at the continuous point. So what will be the continuous point? Either that should be 24.5 or 25.5, but 25 itself is not at the continuous point. So in order to adjust that, what you have to do, you have to adjust this number so that it includes 25 because of this equal sign. So instead of writing 25, now if I jump to the continuous point, I write less than 25.5. Compare these two. When you say less than 25.5, it includes 25 also, and at the same time 25.5 is at continuous point, and in this way we can make the continuity correct. Now I will continue from this point. At this point, this is now at the continuous point that we have seen earlier, and in that case we have to do that, we have to convert that into z distribution, because we are approximating to the normal distribution. And you have already seen before, while learning the normal distribution and also while using those sort of thing in the binomial distribution, z equals to x minus mu by sigma. So here in this case, your probability value will be, when you convert that x into z, it's going to be z is less than x minus, its mu value is 24. So it's 24, and its sigma value, that is variance value, the sigma value is under root of 24. Then in another step, pz is less than x, you are going to find, and it is less, or now it is 25.5, so it is 25.5, and then it is minus than 24, and then divided by under root 24. Then take your calculator. So when I use the calculator, it's going to be, so this answer is, got it for z. So z is less than 0.30618. So I can write here 2. You have to use the table after that. So you have to use the table, use z table. So this sort of table you'll get in the formula book from CIE mathematics courses. So here I have downloaded in order to show you that how to see the table. And because at this time I don't think that I am obliged to show you the table, but just for your reminder, I would like to show you the table. This is the table where you can see the value of z. Yes, this is the standard normal variance table. When I read that value from the normal distribution table, I can see it. I can see that at 0.30. Okay, so you can see here 0.3. So 0.3, you can see in the first column, and 0 means you have to take the next number under 0. So that number is 6179. That number is 6179. And we have already worked up with 0.30. Now we have to work for 6. So you can go to the add area. So you can see that 0.3 is 1, 2, 3, 4. It's in the fourth row. And you remember the fourth row. And then go to the number 6 in the add area. And If I'm counting 1, 2, 3, 4, that value is 22. When I add this, 9 plus 2 is 11, 7 plus 2 is 9, and then this is 0, 10, that is 10, 0 for 10, and then this is 2, and then this is 6. So by using that table, your value is going to be 0.621. So this is your answer. What did you observe here? That why are we going to use normal approximation? Even though we know the formula and idea to solve problem by using Poisson's own formula. Why? Because look at here. So in this case, for example, if you use the formula negative lambda x divided by x factorial, yes, you can do by this formula also. But what happens when you do this formula? You need how many steps? Look at here. So if you write px is less or equals to 25, then you have to start from px equals to 0, 1 plus p2 plus dot 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 plus p up to 25. Can you see how many steps you need to calculate here? You have to have 26 steps to calculate, and that would be just a waste of time, because by using the both the methods, we'll get the same answer or very near answer. Therefore, this is wise not to waste the time, and hence this is important for us to understand how we can approximate the value of probability using the normal approximation. I will now move forward to another question. So I'm going to clear it off. If you like, you can have a look. Okay, now in question number 2, you have to find p 22 less or equals to x, and then less or equals to 26. So listen, in this case also, like here also we require continuity, correct? Because this is not the continuous distribution, therefore require that correction. The same thing I had already talked to you about this problem. And then in the continuous, so you have to look at this inequality. Inequality, both 26 and 22 are included in the set of this inequality. So you cannot remove 22 and 26. And we have to adjust this sort of thing so that 22 and 26 both should be included. So, and also at the same time, 22 and 26 are not the continuous points. We have to take them to the continuous point. So when you need the continuous correction, what happens? You have to put less than here, bigger than, because less or equal to than less than. Alright. So now you can see x bigger or equal to 22. What if you write this is 21.5? It is 21.5. Bigger equal. So 21.5 means x is greater than 21.5, that also includes 22, and 21.5 itself is at continuous point that we have seen in the graph. And for this, this should be less or equal to 26. So I am writing here 26.5. That means it is not including 26.5, but less than 26.5 is also 26. That means we have adjusted this to the continuous point, 26.5, where 26 itself is not the continuous point. Now, this is a turn to convert that into z value, or you can say z statistics also. This is less than, I'm going to write 26.5 minus, this is the position for mean, so mean value we have lambda. So here you have lambda is 24, this is under root 24, and we shall do the similar work to the left. So it is 21.5 minus 24 over the under root 24, and when you use the calculator, that value is going to be negative 0.5103, less than z, that is going to be less than 0.5103. Fortunately, we have got the same values for
either, but they are in the negative sense. If you break it up and you use the concept of the calculation that you have done in the normal distribution, it will be 2 times of 5, 0.5103 and minus 1. This is 2 times of. So when you use table, just like I had shown you, so in that case, the table value for 0.5103 is actually, it is from the table, like 0.6950 minus 1, and that is going to be equals to 0.390 when you use the calculator. So this is our answer for this question. You can have a look for a while.
So now here I have got 2 more examples to explain. So this example says that accidents on a particular railway line occur at an average rate of 1 every 2 months. Find the probability that there are 25 or more accidents in 4 years, 30 or fewer accidents in 5 years, exactly 18 accidents in 3 years. So what you can see in this case, like average rate of 1 every 2 months. So then in first of all, you have to design the distribution. So here, according to the first part of the question, it says that x follows Poisson distribution with lambda value 1. So here lambda is 1 every 2 months, means per 2 months. So now if you talk about question number 1, it says that 25 or more accidents in 4 years. That means 1 or more in 4 years means here lambda is given for 2 months only. Then you have to find the lambda for 4 years now. So you have now for 2 months, okay, so for 2 months the lambda value is 1. So therefore for 1 month the lambda value will be 1 over 2 by using the unitary method or otherwise. Now here 4 years, so you can see that here there is 4 years given for question number 1. If I am talking of question number 1, so for 4 years you can see that the 4 years means it is for 4 times of 12 months, and that means it is 48 months. So in this sense, the lambda for 1 month is half, that means for 48 months it must be lambda equals to half times of 48, and then it is going to be 24 if you divide by 2. Now here you can see that 24 is bigger than 15, so you can say that since lambda is equals to 24, which is bigger than 15, therefore normal approximation to Poisson distribution can be used. So when you apply normal approximation to the Poisson distribution, so then your new value of mean, your mean value in the normal distribution is mu. As you are connecting this to the Poisson distribution, so your lambda is mu is lambda, and the value of lambda is 15, and its variance is sigma square, and that is also given by lambda. That means your standard deviation is the square root of the variance, that is under root of lambda is 24. So therefore your distribution is now x follows Poisson with parametric value lambda equals to 24. And now we can see, yes, it said that to find the probability of 20 or more accidents in 4 years. 25 or more accidents in 4 years. So we have already got the information for 4 years here now. So according to the question, we are now supposed to find the value of question number 1. So it is Px is 25 or more. That means it is bigger equals to 25. And this sort of probability we need to find now. So here in this case now, as this distribution is not a continuous distribution, because Poisson distribution is a discrete distribution, and we are approximating its probability by using the continuous distribution, therefore continuity correction is necessary in this case. So when you make continuity correction to this, then you can see that it is so you can now see that in place of greater equal to sign, if you write this is bigger than 24.5, then this sort of thing includes 25 also. What is the difference between these two things? 25 is discrete point, but 24.5 is the adjusted continuity point. So now we have to convert that into a standard normal variance. So if you continue from this part, then it's going to be Px. Now we have Px is bigger than 24.5. Standard normal variance is x minus mu by sigma here. So if you use this sort of thing, then it is going to be P. Convert that into Z, then it's going to be, and then this is going to be Pz is bigger than, now take the calculator and then find this value. So here in this case, my value is 0.102, and if I round off to 4 significant decimal, then it is going to be, place of 0 is going to be 21. And now by complementary probability theorem, you can use 1 minus P Z is less or equals to 0.1021, and hence you can write this as 1 minus phi 0.1021. Now go to the Z table, that is also called the standard normal distribution table, and then read off this value. So I read off this value from the table. If you can see, so here in this case I have got this Z table ready from CIE formula book. It is going to be 1 minus or 0.1. So if I write 0.1, then another place is Z equal to 0.1021 is 0.5006. And then I will again use calculator. In calculator, I will put this, there should be cosine, and my answer is 0.4594. So I have another question also under the same example. It says that 30 or fewer accidents in 5 years. So in this case, the question is talking about 4 years, but in this case, it's talking about 5 years. So for 4 years, we have got the value of lambda is 24. Now we have to find the value of lambda for 5 years. So you can see here in this case, like for 1 month, I'm working from here. So for 1 month time also, your value of lambda is bigger than 15. Therefore, normal approximation can be applied to this question situation. Now, the question says that like 30 or fewer, that means you have to find in this case Px is 30 or fewer, means less than or equals to 30. And because you know that we are dealing with a discrete distribution, this is not the continuous, but we are making it correct to the continuous, therefore we require the continuity correction. So once you require the continuity correction here, so after the continuity correction, you can see that Px is less or equal to 30. So even though if it is discrete point, if you are making it continuous, your corrected inequality must contain value 30. So in order to do so, you can write x is less than 30.5. So we can make difference of 0.5 from either side. Like you can either add or subtract, depends on how you need, so that this number will be included in the resulting inequality. So if you compare these two values, logically that 30 must be included here. If you write x is less than 3.5, this now includes 30 as well, and at the same time this discrete point is now at the continuous point 30.5. after this step, you have now probability of x is less than 30.5, and now as you are approximating the probability via normal approximation, therefore you have to convert that into a standard normal variance. So if you write it there, this is less than, so this is x minus mu by sigma you have seen here, so its x value is 30.5, and its new value, because mean and variances are same for the quotient distribution, and therefore your mu value for this distribution is now lambda, and lambda is 30, you can see here, and sigma, the variance is also lambda, therefore standard deviation is under the root lambda. So here the lambda value is 30, so we can write here mu value is 30, and then a standard deviation value is under root of 30. Then close it. Now calculate this value. What happens? 30.5 minus 30, that means it is 0.5, and divided by under root 30 and close the bracket. My answer is here 0. So I can see here that PZ less than it is 0.09128. That means 0.0913. So that is 0.0913. I will now again go to the table and then I will check the value. Our answer in this case is equals to 0.5368. So this is the answer for another question in the same example. 5363 is our answer. Now let's check what we are left with. Now lastly, the question says that exactly 18 accidents in 3 years. So in question number 3, your lambda value will be for 3 years. For 1 year this is half, then for 3 years there is 36 months, so you can write 36. This is 18, and here also this is bigger than 15. Therefore, normal approximation to Poisson distribution can be applied. So at this point you have to find exactly 18 accidents in 3 years. So we have already got the value of lambda for 3 years. So exactly 18 accidents. That means you have to find the probability Px equals to 18. Because this is the discrete point and we are approximating this value of probability by using the continuous distribution. So while taking the continuity correction, make sure that if you are using any inequality or any sort of mathematical language, that must include this point 18. So if I want to do the thing so that 18 will be included, and also there will be points on continuous place. So here it is x. If I write less than 18.5, then it is bigger than 17.5. Now let's see that 18 is between 17.5 and 18.5, and 18 itself is at discrete point, but 17.5 and 18.5 are the connecting point to the other values in the continuous set of, in the adjusted sort of continuous set of data. Therefore, our continuity correction work is done here. Now, next step is that we have to convert this into a standard normal variate. So, after that, when I convert that into a standard normal variate, it will become Z and less than and greater than. So, at this point, your X value is 18.5 minus your new value is 18, and your standard deviation value is root 18, and similar thing you can do with 17.5. So it is 17.5 minus mu value is 18, that is lambda. So this is 18 divided by under root of 18. So after this step, if you use calculator, then after some calculation, and that's the concept you have used in normal distribution problem solving area, and then if you use that concept, it will be 2 times of 5. And then this your 5 value from the calculator is 0.118, and then minus 1. And then after that, it is 2 points of, if you go to the Z table and if you read out from the Z table, your this value is going to be 0.5470 minus 1 here. And finally, once you know, when you calculate it, then it will be 0.0904, and this is the answer. Finally, let's discuss about one more example. So you can have a look at this example. You can see, so this is the problem example. Now you have to understand the problem first. So the, it said that the number of pulse per square meters, what it is given here, is given that per square meter of a particular type of cloth is denoted by x. So lambda value is, you can see that the number of pulse per square meter a particular cloth is denoted by x. Now state the condition that must be satisfied for x to follow a Poisson distribution. So what will the condition for that? Condition for that is the event should occur independently, singly, and at a constant rate. So what you can write here, if you are talking of question number 1, events occur or should occur, you can write should occur. So events occur randomly, independently, singly, and at a constant average rate. So this is the main condition that represents that the given random variable follows Poisson distribution. Therefore, this is the answer for the condition that must be satisfied for x to follow a Poisson distribution. Now we shall go to question number 2, and in question number 2 you can see that the question number 2 states that here. So now it says that assume that So it is saying that next x follows Poisson distribution with parametric value 0.8. That means it is lambda is 0.8. Find the probability that there are no faults in 2 square meters. It is for 1 square meter. According to the Poisson, you can see that for square meter, and this lambda value is for per square meter. Now in Poisson number 2a, it is talking of 2 square meters. So for 1 square meter, your lambda value is 0.8. Therefore, for 2 square meters, it is obvious that your lambda value is 2 times of 0.8, and then this is 1.6. And here in this case, you can see that your lambda value is not bigger than 15. So that is, in fact, less than 15. So therefore, we shall resort to the Poisson distribution itself. So now let's see in this question number A, it says that find the probability that. So here now your distribution is x follows Poisson with parametric value 1.6. So according to this question number A, there are no faults in 2 square meter. That means x is equals to 0. And then you, if you use the formula for the Poisson distribution, that e to the power minus lambda to the power x divided by x factorial for x equals to 0, 1, 2, and up to infinity. Now e to the power, your lambda value is negative 1.6. And lambda to the power 0 is 1, and 0 factor is also 1, so you don't need to write all these things. So just if you write e to the power negative 1.6, that will work. Now go to the calculator and then check for value of this e to the power negative 1.6. You can see this value, as my value is 0.202. I'm taking out to 3 significant thing. This is the answer. Now in question number B. Question number B, you can see like at least 2 faults in 3 square meters. So in this case, you have to calculate the lambda for 3 square meter. So your lambda for 3 square meter in this case will be 2.4. Now this is again less than 15. So therefore, no normal approximation is appropriate in this case. Therefore, we apply the formula for Poisson distribution in order to find the probability that there are at least 2 faults in 3 square meters. So we have lambda for 3 square meters. So in this case, at least 2 means it should be greater or equals to 2, at least 2. So in this case, if you use the complementary probability theorem, you can write this way: 1 minus px is less than 2. That means it is 1 minus px is equals to less than 2 means px equals to 0 plus px equals to 1. Okay, but it doesn't contain value 2 because it said that this is less than 2. Now if you apply the formula of Poisson distribution, like px equals to x equals to e to the power minus lambda x by x factorial, is going to be 1 minus e to the power minus lambda, so e to the power negative lambda, and lambda value is here 2.4. so this is negative 2.4 is outside, and inside this is the place of lambda here. So things are like this: 1 minus e to the power minus lambda, then it is lambda by 1 factorial plus 0 and 1. So to the power 0, then it should be 1. Yes, it should be 1, and then this is lambda by 1 factorial, and like this. So in the usual way, we can apply the sense that we used to calculate the value of this probability. So here px equal to 0 means e to the power negative 2.4 has already been taken common. So here it is left with 1, and then it is left with lambda value. So lambda value is 2.4, and then it is 1 minus e to the power negative 2.4 times it is 1 plus 2 is 3.4. Now in the calculator, we can calculate this value. So our final answer is 0.69, and there is 5 in the neighborhood of 1. Therefore, this is 2, and this is the answer of this question. So we have already done up to question number 2a and b. And in those questions, as lambdas were not bigger than 15, so we have to resort to the same probability distribution formula for this Poisson distribution. Now let's see in question number 3 that what happens here. Question 3, you can see that it says that clothes is stored on rolls, each containing 100 square meter of cloth. So in that case, if you see that your value of lambda, in question number 3, if I am talking, the value of x is distributed as Poisson 0.8. So it is lambda is 0.8 or 1 square meter, but the question number 3 is talking about 100 square meter. Therefore, for 100 square meter, your lambda value is 0.8 times 100, and this is 80. And we have seen that this 80 is bigger than 15. Therefore, applying normal approximation to the portion with parametric value, 80 is appropriate. That is appropriate. So therefore, if you are using the normal approximation, so therefore it's going to be your value of mu is going to be lambda, and also you know that variance is also lambda for the Poisson distribution. So lambda value is 80, and here also the variance, that is sigma square value, is 80. Therefore, it's a standard deviation, that means under root of sigma square is sigma, so this is under root of lambda is, it is under root of 80. Now it says that find the probability that a roll of clothes contain more than 100 fold. So it is asking you to find the probability that x is more than 100. It says that you can see here, find the probability that a roll of clothes contains more than 100 folds. Poisson distribution is not a continuous distribution, but we are going to approximate the value of probability by using the continuous distribution like normal approximation. Therefore, there must be continuity correction before we calculate the given probability. So here, if you apply continuity correction, and then that is going to be px is greater or equals to 100.5. You can see that 100 is discrete point and 100.5 is the at continuous point. That is the point of connection in the continuous point. And also, if you talk about x is bigger than 100, that means it contains all the values bigger than 100 but not 100. Therefore, after continuity correction, if you write this way, that means you have added 0.5 to this number, then this point is at connecting point, and hence the continuity correction has been completed at this step. Now proceed further from that step, then it is going to be, let me write it again, px is greater or equals to 100.5. Now you have to convert that into z variate, that is the standard normal variate. So z is greater or equals to, this is x value, then another place is for mu, and then the denominator there is the place for standard deviation, that is sigma. After this step, z is greater or equals to value of x at this point is 100.5, then mu value is 80 divided by sigma value is under root 80, then it is you can write also 1 minus p z is less than. Now let's calculate. So my calculator value shows that if I am taking up to 3 decimal places, it will be 2.292. So this is 1 minus, if I again go to the table, the z table, and that I have already explained. And so by using the z table, my value is 1 minus 0.9891. And after calculating from this step, so my final answer is going to be 0.0109. This is the answer. Okay, these were some of the examples that I explained here, and I now hope that you will be able to most of the sums and probably all of the sums from your group exercises. So that's all for now.